Hello, dear learners. I am Devraj Goyal from CIET of NCERT, New Delhi, India. Today we will focus on Learner Driven Pedagogy From Constructivism to Connectivism. It is under the course Perspectives, Issues and Research in Teacher Education. Let us delineate the objectives. After going through this module, the learners will be able to differentiate behaviorism, cognitivism, constructivism and connectivism. They will be in a position to employ learner-driven pedagogy, will be in a position to employ constructivism and connectivism. The focus of the present topic is learner-driven pedagogy. It demands a shift from teacher-driven pedagogy to learner-driven pedagogy. Only teacher-driven pedagogy fails. The concern is realization of learner identity and transcendence from dependent to independent learning through constructivism to connectivism. It examines the probability of the human brain to cognize the entire cosmos. It tries to find meaning with the connectivism and realize the need for connectivism and education and teacher education. It focuses on learner-driven pedagogy through constructivism and then the notes and links for connectivism and explores the history and the methods of learning connectivism. Then it presents the importance of networks, foundations and principles of connectivism. A comparative view of cognitivism, behaviorism, constructivism and connectivism has also been presented. Skills of connectivism find expression followed by some illustrations on connectivism. Finally, it concludes how connectivism provides the pathways for connecting dot to globe and point to morphology. Now, let us focus on human brain capacity. The human brain has more than 1 billion nerve cells, which are interconnections as follows. The emerging question is, can the human brain reconstruct and cognize the entire universe? There is no answer as such. Further, what is reconstruction and storage mechanism? How are the schemas designed and stored? How is the connectivity amongst the whole of cosmos? How are the images formed and stored? It demands collective wisdom to connect with and cognize the universe. How are these bonds formed? What is connectivity? To what extent it has been realized in education and teacher education? Heart and brain entrainment. When a person feels content or calm, his brainwave patterns entrain with the heart rate variability patterns, a measurable synchronicity between the heart rate and brain waves occurs. The heart, not the brain, sets the pace. When a person becomes fearful, this synchronicity is broken off. The heart rate variability patterns become jagged and disordered. But more significantly, the brain wave patterns become unrelated to the heart rate patterns. When fearful or under stress, brain waves cease to be entrained with the heart rate variability patterns. When the fear is over, the brain's wave patterns can again become entrained with the heart wave patterns, realizing dopamine and adrenaline equation. Now, the emerging questions. Can the human brain reconstruct and cognize the entire universe? What is reconstruction and storage mechanism? How are the schemas designed and stored? How is the connectivity amongst the whole of cosmos? How are the images formed and stored? How are the bonds formed? What is connectivity? To what extent it has been realized in education and teacher education? Now, let's focus on constructivism. This universe becomes meaningful when we are in a position to realize interrelation and interdependence with its constituents. It demands knowledge of the universe. Knowledge of the universe demands organized search, that is research. This research is an infinite, that is never-ending process. But more and more we know about the universe, more and more ease we have in life and living. It has to be more of learner-driven. The pedagogy may be teacher-designed or learner-designed, but for knowledge and learning, it has to be essentially learner-driven. learner-driven pedagogy demands experiential learning. In this process of conversing with the universe, there are both discovery and construction. Discovery involves recursive research, whereas construction demands germination of the ideas, its incubation, creation, and expression. Many approaches are on the fore for construction called constructivism. Many models of constructivism have come up, such as 5E model and 7E model, wherein the learners have immersion into a particular domain called engagement, its exploration, explanation, elaboration, and extension. Our existence becomes more meaningful when we do both, that is, discovery and construction. Now, some illustrations of constructivism. A trainer trains a learner on car driving, particularly on ABC, that is, accelerator, brake, and clutch. Trainer-driven and dependent pedagogy fails the learner, whereas the learner-driven pedagogy passes. Every learner has to experience accelerator, brake, and clutch on one's own. Sooner the learner realizes independence, better is the learning. Driving demands experiential learning. Now, moving a static ball, a ball rolls and stops deep under a court. A child hits the ball with another ball from outside. Both the balls roll out. The learner-driven pedagogy works and works very well, more so because it has been designed, developed, and implemented by the learner. There could be a number of alternatives for solving the problem, but the one where the learner has exercised discretion works and works very well. Now, two beetles crossing a road, rolling spherical seeds. Two beetles were crossing a road breadthwise, rolling a spherical seed. They were having full hold of the seeds. The push, the pull, momentum and control, all were marvelous. It was a highly fascinating stimulus for the passers-by. The learner-driven pedagogy worked very well. Now, ready-made products, learner retardation. Guides are readily available in the markets. Question bank with solutions are available. It has become customary to copy-paste without mental processing. Now, drill and practice are negligible. Experts-driven pedagogy fails many a novice. Now, programmed learners. Children are programmed round the clock. Beauties of childhood are lost. Booming energy of the adolescents goes stray. Vision of the adults is lost. There is rare life in the institutes of education, but added focus on the life skills. Where are we learners? Dwindling values and institutions. Degeneration of values and institutions. Technological deschooling. Mechanized education. There is a felt need for germination, incubation, innovation, creation, construction, and connection. Ways out. Technological deschooling. Zero lecture program. Participatory approach of problem solving. Activity-based learning, employing models of teaching, theory building, and employing taxonomy of educational skills, constructivism and connectivism, training thinking, holistic learning. Features of some of the innovative programs, such as personalized teacher education, DAVB, that is Devi Ahilya Vishwavidyalaya, choice of volunteers, learner-centered, personalized classroom setting, participatory approach, ZLP, that is zero lecture program, freedom for what to study and how to study, when to study, where to study, peer teaching, learning, and evaluation, variety in the modes of presentation, successive discussions, evaluation by self, peer, and teacher, then emergence of humanistic and professional masters, holistic teacher education at the Center of Advanced Study in Education. The syntax is subject knowledge, interdisciplinarity, environmental attitude, health development, emotional development, spiritual development, and integrated development. Universe Development Index, UDI. Problem solving through participatory approach at the Devi Ahilya Vishwavidyalaya. The MCED class, DAVB, Indore, was very often given a problem to be solved through a computer program. Number of different programs emerged from the entire class. each program was presented by one of the programmers to the rest of the class and rated by all the students on different criteria, namely compactness of source code, fetch and execute cycle size, response time, memory used, programming discipline level, and program intelligibility. Also, the students developed a program to calculate Kendall's coefficient of concordance through C language. Then they computed Kendall's coefficient of concordance individual criterion wise and with respect to the comprehensive criteria. There is a significant cognitive development through cognitively mapping the algorithms and solutions to a problem. This approach cuts across students of varied profiles simultaneously. Participatory approach may be introduced in various disciplines to enhance learning in all domains. It facilitates creative production and independent thinking. Also, it provides scope to experience and appreciate the cognitive maps of others. Development of creative writing ability among students through participatory approach at case. Recitation of model poems by the teacher in class situation. Then, appreciation of the poems by the class and identification of the various components of creative composition. After that, composition of a variety of poems by the students individually and in groups. Recitation of the self-composed poems by the classmates and appreciation by rest of the class. Participatory approach of creative expression of the latent creative faculties in terms of original production. Now, learner-driven pedagogy with constructivism. Here is a poem presenting learner-driven pedagogy. Mere trainer-driven pedagogy failed me grossly as a learner. Accelerator, brake, clutch and gear was full of diffidence and fear. Fully learner-driven pedagogy passed me gracefully as a learner, driving easily in any direction with confidence and conviction. Driving demands knowledge of techniques, driving demands motor muscle skills, driving demands concept of space and time, driving drives both body and mind. Driving tunes with multivariate setting, driving rules with multiple controls. Driving has its own methodology, driving has its own science and technology. Driving drives self and vehicle, driving derives concepts and principles. Driving is full of arrays of skills, slight negligence bumps, hurts and kills. Driving demands a taxonomy of skills, compatible drivers, ways and vehicles. Whether driving man or machine, driving demands wit, will and skills. Pedals with or against currents, lift, thrust, ailerons and rudder pedals, let us drive hill, valleys, plains, all the ways, up, down, back, forth, left, right, all the days, replacement of SMPS, insertion of CMOS, fixing of RAM, fabrication of chips, spring tide, sun, moon, opposite side, drive universe with wit, might and delight, clouds in the sky, rains and storms, dew drops on petals, sweat of the workers, salute to thee for thy grace, resonating drive, always, always. Now, electrons in orbits, ribosome in DNA, all the entities in wonderful constellation. Connectivism is a hypothesis of learning which emphasizes the role of social and cultural, often associated with, and proposes a perspective similar to Vygotsky's zone of proximal development, ZPD, an idea later transposed into Engstrom's 2001 activity theory. The relationship between work experience learning and knowledge as expressed in the concept of connectivity and connectivism motivating the theory's name. It is somewhat similar to Bandura's social learning theory that proposes that people learn through contact. The phrase, a learning theory for the digital age, indicates the emphasis that connectivism gives to technology's effect on how people live, communicate, and learn. Those who struggle to create an adequate theory of learning must admit that the process is much like stumbling in the dark. So much of our thought structure is shaped by hidden assumptions evident in our existing learning and educational systems, Simons 2005. Connectivism is a learning theory for the digital age. Learning has transformed from the last several decades. The theory of behaviorism, cognitivism, and constructivism provide an effect view of learning in many and related environments respectively. Connectivism basically postulates that learning occurs through connections within the networks. The connectivism comprises of the networks with nodes and connections to define the learning. Constructivism highlighted on the construction of knowledge and meaning-making activity and applying the known to the unknown. Here in connectivism, the generated knowledge gets networked with other new knowledge and the network develops and moves on. It is the philosophy of learning where the knowledge constructed consists of connections between entities in a network. Also, the learning consists of developing and traversing these networks. It asserts that knowledge and learning are of not completely the content but about the connections. Constructivism, in which it has an ontology, in which reality is subjective, a social product constructed and interpreted by learners. Hence, social constructivism places a great emphasis on the importance of social interactions in affecting the individual's generation of knowledge or facts about the world. The whole is greater than the sum of the parts, and knowledge becomes a cultural artifact associated with groups within a specific context. Let's focus on the nodes and links. The central aspect of connectivism is the metaphor of a network connections. In this metaphor, a node is anything that can be connected to another node, such as an organization, information, data, feeling, and images. Connectivism sees learning as the process of creating connections and expanding or increasing network complexity. Not all connections are of equal strength. The idea of organizations as cognitive systems, where knowledge is distributed across nodes and from the perception and is directly borrowed from connectionism, a paradigm in cognitive sciences that sees mental or behavioral phenomena as the emergent processes of interconnected networks of simple units. The network metaphor allows a notion of nowhere, the understanding of where to find the knowledge when it is needed, to supplement to the ones of know-how and know-what that make the cornerstones of many theories of learning. As Darwin states, at its heart, connectivism is the thesis that knowledge is distributed across a network of connections and therefore that learning consists of the ability to construct and traverse those networks. Now, the history and foundations of connectivism. Connectivism was introduced in 2005 by two publications, Simon's Connectivism, Creation, and Downs, An Introduction to Connective Knowledge. Both works received significant attention in the blogosphere, and an extended discourse has followed on the appropriateness of connectivism and its learning theory for the digital age. In 2007, Kerr entered into the debate with a series of lectures and talks on the matter, as did Forrester, both at the online connectivism conference at the University of Manitoba in 2008, in the context of digital and e-learning. Connectivism was considered and its technological implications were discussed by Simons and Ali. Each and every idea has their own heritages. Likewise, the idea of the connectivism too has the roots. Like language as a tool of learning in social constructivism of Lev theory of Vygotsky, Brunner, Bandura's self-efficacy, network theories of mathematics, sociology, and physics. Now, let us focus on the teaching methods. Summarizing connectivist teaching and learning, Dovin states, To teach is to model and demonstrate. To learn is to practice and reflect. In 2008, Simons and Dobbins delivered an online course called Connectivism and Connective Knowledge. It covered connectivism as content while attempting to implement some of their ideas. The course was free to anyone who wished to participate, and over 2,000 people worldwide enrolled. The phrase Massive Open Online Course (MOOC) describes this model. All course content was available through RSS feeds, and learners could participate with their choices of tools, threaded discussions in Moodle, blog posts, Second Life, and synchronous online meetings. The course was repeated in 2009 and in 2011. Those who struggled to create an adequate theory of learning must admit that the process is much like stumbling in the dark. So much of our thought structure is shaped by hidden assumptions evident in our existing learning and educational systems. Simons, 2005. Connectivism is a learning theory for the digital age. Learning has transformed from the last several decades. Theories of behaviorism, cognitivism, and constructivism provide an effective view of learning in many and related environments, respectively. Connectivism basically postulates that learning occurs through connections within the networks. The connectivism comprises of the networks with nodes and connections to define the learning. Constructivism highlighted on the construction of knowledge and meaning-making activity and applying the known to the unknown. Here in connectivism, the generated knowledge gets networked with other new knowledge, and the network develops and moves on. It is the philosophy of learning where the knowledge constructed consists of connections between entities in a network. Also, the learning consists of developing and traversing these networks. It asserts that knowledge and learning are of not completely the content but about the connections. Behaviorism offers laws to govern behavior that can inform a teacher's manipulation of the learning environment, including texts and activities to promote learning, where knowledge is perceived as facts that can be transmitted from teacher to students. Cognitivism opens up the black box of the mind regarding the learner as an information processor. Social constructivism, in which it has an ontology in which reality is subjective, a social product constructed and interpreted by learners. Hence, social constructivism places a greater emphasis on the importance of social interactions in affecting the individual generation of knowledge or facts about the world. The whole is greater than the sum of the parts, and knowledge becomes a cultural artifact associated with groups within a specific context. Now, importance of networks. According to Simons, considering technology and meaning making as learning activities begins to move learning into the digital age, 2005. Inherent to this new viewpoint on learning is the idea that we can no longer personally experience everything there is to experience, and we try to learn something new. We must create networks which simply define our connections between entities. By using these networks of people, of technology, of social structures, of systems, of power grids, etc., learning communities can share their ideas with others, thereby cross-pollinating the learning environment. Simon, 2005. Dawes and Simons have brought together their ideas on the use of networks in understanding learning on many levels in a theory called connectivism. Simons sets a bold research agenda around the sharing of cognitive tasks between people and technology, coping with rapid change in the information ecology and the impact of theories of networks, complexity, and chaos. He defines a network as connections between entities, which he calls nodes. The nodes can be individuals, groups, systems, fields, ideas, or communities. The networks are basically in two forms. One, internally as neural networks, where knowledge is distributed across our brain, not held in entirely in one location. Then two, externally as networks, we actively form. Each node represents an element of specialization, and the aggregate represents our ability to be aware of, learn, and adapt to the world around. Darwin draws the concept of connectivism as it has been used when applying ideas from biological models of the brain to neural networks in machine learning, treating the neural network as part of a whole. The overall view that a strongly interconnected neural network and its patterns must be considered as part of a whole became an important principle of orientation in the study of the nervous system. It is referred to under the name of connectivism, Guest G, 1990. Now, the principles of connectivism. According to Simon, 2005, knowledge and the learning rests in the diversity of opinions. Learning is a process of connecting specialized nodes for information sources. Learning may reside in non-human appliances. Capacity to know more is more critical than what is currently known. Nurturing and maintaining connections is needed to facilitate continual learning. Ability to see connections between fields, ideas, and concepts is a core skill. Currency, accurate, up-to-date knowledge is the intent of all connectivist learning activities. Decision-making is itself a learning process. Choosing what to learn and the meaning of incoming information is seen through the lens of a shifting reality. While there is a right answer now, it may be wrong tomorrow due to the alterations in information climate affecting the decision. Dear learners, as you can observe from this table, the various attributes of behaviorism, cognitivism, constructivism, and connectionism theories of learning. It depicts different aspects of learning in terms of how does learning occur, factors influencing learning, role of memory, drill and practice, repeated experiences, how does transfer occur, and types of learning and their best explanation. Connectionist skills, interpretation of units, activation of the network of units, learning algorithm, recurrent neural networking, evolving continuous dynamic systems approaches. Now, illustrations on connectivism, learning resources management system, time space personnel management system, consortium of teacher education, inter-university consortium, Global Educational Research Association, GERA, Indian Consortium of Research in Education, ICOR, Holistic Education, then Taxonomy of Educational Skills, Social Networking, Management Information System Series, MIS, Reflective Dialoguing. Now, let us conclude. In connectionism, the starting point is always the individual learner, Simon 2005. The path to gaining knowledge comes through an individual, possibly with the assistance of others, establishing their own personal knowledge network of relevant information resources. For example, valuable websites, academic or professional journals, conferences, etc., and information connections. These connections may consist of relationships with knowledgeable co-workers or professional colleagues. Connectivism provides a new way of relationships with knowledgeable co-workers or professional colleagues. Connectivism provides a new way of thinking about knowledge and learning in the context of emerging information technology and rapid change. Knowledge should no longer be considered a stable artifact to be passed from one person to another, but instead should be viewed as a process always changing and growing. Connectivism provides the pathways for connecting dot to globe and point to morphology. Thank you.